my friends.
So this trench is going to be for our power and our water supply to the greenhouse.
Mm-hmm.
And our well is connected to the house already. So we're just going to tie into that with the pressure tank, get that into the greenhouse, and we're going to have multiple faucets sink in there for prepping and cleaning vegetables. We have very hard water and we have
lots of calcium.
Lots of calcium. Oh.
Here, let me hold that.
Okay. But it's all over the windshield. And then we have two other trenches,
mm-hmm.
which are from the burner over here,
mm-hmm.
which is going to heat the house. And then we're going to have an alternative heat source in the geothermal greenhouse for when we hit very cold temperatures.
Ooh, there's a stellar jay. Okay, let's keep trenching.
Thank you. Good thing I'm skinny. It's a really coily line. So I have to pull it and then go and uncoil it and then pull it and then go and uncoil it and then go and pull it.
Oh, so do you need some help?
It's kind of awkward. You need to have long arms like me and you don't. But the trenching is done, except for, so I bedded it with sand. Mm-hmm. And you bed it with sand for, just to protect the line. If you have rocks on it and then there's any settlements or shifting, they can puncture the line.
Okay, wait. So let's back up. So we dug, a trench.
We trenched the trench with the trencher.
How deep is it?
I don't have my tape, but close to 4 feet. A little deeper in some spots.
And you think that that's gonna not freeze?
I am also gonna, I have chunks of insulation from the rammed earth. Uh-huh. And I'm gonna, so put more sand on top after I run the electrical and then insulation. And I don't think it's gonna freeze.
Okay.
But I'm also gonna put a blowout on it. I don't think it'll freeze. When I dug around last year on a few places, it was like 18 inches at most.
Okay.
Where the frost went down to. And we were minus 37.
I know.
For like 2 weeks or whatever it was.
So this is the water line or the?
It's water. Okay. Yeah. Water for your greenhouse to water stuff with.
Blue for water.
Yeah. Municipal line. Oh, you're gonna have to probably find those guys.
Can we just take a moment to look at your phone?
Oh no.
It's yeah.
That's how come I always need a new phone. What's this?
Weird.
You look like a mountain goat, like you're wondering where to walk. Hardly fit through here. Shouldn't have had that extra beer.
It's so sketchy.
Sketchy.
Well, I've never seen anybody do this before.
I've never done this before. Not in anything this skinny.
It's getting skinnier, babe.
Yeah, the worst part is turning your feet around. It's like, bend them in a weird way.
Like up and over?
It's getting skinnier.
It is.
Well, there's benefits and there's, I guess, pros and cons to this stuff here. Okay. Oh, frick. I don't know if I can pull it anymore. I think I gotta go uncoil it now. Like I said, it gets all snagged, snarled up. Once I get it through that conduit, it's good. It stays reasonably good.
Okay, so what do you want me to do?
I gotta go back, pull it, feed it into the crawl space under the house.
Mm-hmm.
Go into the crawl space, pull it over to where we have to connect it.
Mm-hmm.
And then pull it over to our... box. So we got like, I'm gonna have like a bunch of valves in here for the hose bibs, but the main feed's gonna come up there to different valves so you can turn it on and off what you want. So the water line's gonna go up through more conduit up into there, and then that's all underground. Try not to kick anything in the hole when you walk over.
Okay.
So I just gotta, I'm gonna get it because it's a little bit tangly. Okay, don't put too much pressure on it. Just enough to.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna put sand on it.
Okay.
Okay.
Jojo, give me your paw.
Focus, pig.
Jojo.
Oh. You're good.
Stan?
Yeah.
Okay, there's another spot up here.
It's so cute.
Wow. We have a trench inspector
Clyde
with his nose to the ground to make sure it's good.
How was it?
Yeah,
all those smells, those under the earth smells. Come on, buddy. Good boy. You got the power?
The power. It's 175 feet.
Of power?
Like 53 meters or something like that. And then you can see the conduits. Way back when we sleeved it, so that's where the water line's going, is through the footing. Underneath.
Oh, you did that already when we did the footings.
Yeah. It's a little slidey spot. Cool, right?
Yeah. Okay. And here's the end of the trench coming into the greenhouse. Hi, Clyde. This is ridiculous.
You're telling me.
You want help?
I don't know. Doesn't like.
That usually means yes.
You'd think it would be easier, but it's not.
You want it in a hole?
Yeah. This thing is like making me a little bit angry.
Okay, let me find somewhere to put the camera.
No, it's okay, I got it. It's just... I'm sure there's an easier way. Help a little.
Does it matter where I start filling it in?
You're best to start on that side and work your way along.
Okay.
And then you can have an idea of how much you're putting in there. Like, you can do this whole side.
Yeah.
Work your way along. And then you'll have an idea of how much is in there, and then can go in, just whatever we're gonna say. What if you, I give you this and you do it like this? Bit.
I should probably help you instead of filming. Hopefully that's a good angle. You want me to just hold it at the end?
If you dig and then you get it, you'll see it.
I'm digging now and I got dirt in the boot.
Yep.
Better put it back in there.
Welcome to the club.
I don't want to be in your dirty club.
Oh,